boss has taken over Santa's workshop. He plans to deliver bombs and guns to children instead of, you know, dolls and trucks or whatever it is kids from your time like. The elves have mounted a resistance, but they will fail unless you help them. If Klaus succeeds, the holidays are doomed. You must stop him.
Here we are.
My workshop is just ahead.
It's hard to say what Klaus has turned it into.
And Mrs. Klaus? What about her?
Oh, I wouldn't worry. If I know my wife, I bet she's decking the halls as we speak. And is that Dancer? Dancer? Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, sweet Cupid. Vixen, what have they done?
Shawnee! Protect Kringle!
I didn't come here to observe, child. I'm taking the North Pole back.
Yeah, Santa, you tell him!
You're here.
What's going on, Denzel?
Klaus has taken over the workshop. He's turned Twinkle and the boys from shipping and receiving against us.
Klaus isn't going to get over.
Twinkle even created a fleet of evil mechanical reindeer.
So this is where the reign of mechanical animals began. We're clear! Looks like the workshop is ahead.
Mary has enacted emergency shutdown.
Klaus probably wants to use those mechanical rain...
Claws killed my precious reindeer friends and made these abominations.
Claws is one twisted you-know-what.
You-know-what?
I am not going to swear in front of S-A-N-T-A.
It's okay, dearie. Naughty words aren't naughty deeds.
This is by far the worst thing I've ever done with my hand. That's all the robo-deer here. There are other stables around.
I'll take you there.
Okay, we're done here.
Santa, your time is over.
Twinkle, how could you?
Claus gave us a better deal, Plumpy. Weekends off, sick pay, and we get to make guns. Real ones.
He's on the move. My goodness. Claus has turned Twinkle and his cohorts into giant elves.
Shit, where are they?
Right there. Can't you see?
I just see normal-sized people, Nick.
Normal size to you, but giant for elves. Twinkle, my most trusted elf. He's been with me so long, I can't believe he betrayed me.
It'll be okay, Santa. Right?
Right. Yeah, right.
Wow, boss. Real convincing.
No way Claus is getting out now. What's next?
We have to get into the workshop.
Are you seriously feeling nothing here? Christmas is dying right before your eyes.
Sorry, Sean, he just doesn't do anything for me.
That is so sad.
Okay, here's the packing area.
This is where the magic happens.
And where the magic will die if we don't act soon.
Don't say that, Santa. We're going to stop Claus. We're going to fix the future.
With the front closed off, the only way into the workshop is through the present sorter.
Do you have any shiny red paper?
Shandy, dear, can you be a good girl and stay here? If we don't make it, you have to tell the others.
I'm not leaving your side, Santa.
I need you to do this for me, Shandy.
What? I've come too far to stop now. Do you know what I've been through? I've lost friends, compatriots, my arm.
And an eye.
Yes, and an eye. I can't just give you up, Santa.
This is about something much bigger than me, Shandy. This is about Christmas. And those other holidays, too.
Fine. Fine. I'll stay. But don't forget about me.
Thank you, dear. I won't.
Your gumdrops, Cookie.
Oh, honey, you're okay.
No time to talk. The elves and I are kicking ass.
Like I said, she's decking the
halls. Mrs. C, you're speaking my language.
Protect this Claus!
I love the smell of burnt icing in the morning. Your gumdrops, Cookie.
Here. What happened?
Twinkle turned everyone against us. Me and the elf resistance have been trying to protect the pole.
Is it safe?
You know it, hun. But this fight is far from over.
Why? The North Pole is a weapon?
The North Pole is whatever you need it to be.
But mainly, yeah. It's a weapon.
Oh, I think you'll find something special for you, too.
Special, eh? Oh, Santa, you got me a...
What's Christmas without some music?
Hey there, Santa. How are you? Don't you know your days are through?
Claus, you fiend!
Stay back, dear. We got this.
I'm fighting too, honey.
Your army never will give me pause, for none can stop the mighty Claus. Grab the fat man quickly, you, and grab his little helper too. Get the North Pole, bring it here. We must end this Christmas cheer.
Hey, where'd that animal Claus go?
Some other simulation, I guess.
I thought taking out his reindeer would stop him.
The sleigh can take us wherever we want to go.
Our workshop is in shambles.
It's all right, hon. We'll fix this. We'll rebuild. Right, kid?
Don't worry about a thing, Crinkle.
Gingerbread must die! Die, Gingy!
Wait, what about that Shondi girl?
Claus is holed up under a protective shield, gaining strength. At midnight, he'll be unstoppable. Unless you can bring holiday cheer back to the people before the clock strikes 12. Use Santa's sleigh to deliver presents to those on the nice list. And punish the naughty with coal. Hopefully we can kill the bastard and save your future from the hell I've lived.
Step one, fly sleigh. Step two, spread holiday cheer. How do I do step two?
It's really quite simple. You must deliver presents to the nice girls and boys and send coals to those who are naughty.
Easy. I can do that.
Oh, believe me. Try visiting the entire world in a single evening before you say it's easy. Though, as my junior Santa, I'm sure you'll do just fine.
He called me Junior Santa.
Careful. Claus has even turned the weather against you if you fly too high.
Gift-giving time.
And don't forget coal delivery. That's very important, too.
Coal doesn't bring cheer, though, does it?
It reminds people that they have to be better if they want to be on the nice list. After all, nobody wants to be on the naughty list.
What does it take to be on the nice list? For me, for instance.
You've come a long way since you rescued me. But you still need to understand the true giving spirit of the holidays.
I won't let you down, Santa. Moving on.
Wake up and get your presents, people!
You don't want them to wake up. It's important you make deliveries while people still sleep in their beds.
If people saw you, they'd have even more holiday spirit. So why hide?
That's a story I'm sure you're not interested in.
Come on, you could tell your junior censor.
Well, there may have been an incident with a mother attacking me under some mistletoe. When Mary saw the lipstick on my fur collar, I told her it wasn't my fault. But ever since then, she's insisted I only deliver presents while everyone's asleep.
I bet the mother was a good kisser, all right. Naughty and you know it, here's some coal. If you're naughty and you know it, here's some coal. If you're naughty and you know it, then the flames will surely show it. If you're naughty and you know it, here's some coal.
That's quite a catchy song. Would you mind if I sang it on future holidays?
As long as I keep the licensing rights.
It in your heart to defeat Claws. Remember to embrace the spirit of the season.
Thanks, Santa. I will.
It's almost midnight. You have to hurry.
The spirit's alive, but still I stand. Once you're dead, I'll corrupt this land.
Oh, snowballs!
Boss, are you all right?
Keep your shirt on, I'm fine.
Don't worry, dear. We're here to give out a holiday beating.
Well, we didn't crack Claws' shield. What now?
The spirit is stirring, but this city leans heavy on the naughty side. Like the different symbols of the season. And maybe these people will come around.
Gotta reload.
Julius Claws is out.
What is this pole, and how do I light it on fire?
How can you not know what a Festivus pole is?
You need to perform a feat of strength!
So much for the pole.
Now we all have to bitch at each other.
Come again?
It's called airing grievances.
I can't stand those diet cookies you bake me. They...
My turn.
I'm sick and tired of how everyone takes it for granted that I'm always going to hack this or find information on that or know where to go and what to do next. Do I ever get a bonus or some gift for doing all this for you? No.
The spaceship, Kinsey? We gave it to you.
Oh. Yeah, I guess you did. Well, never mind then. What about you, Pierce? You always complain about something. Let's hear it.
Nah, I'm cool.
Come on, you can't be serious.
Really? I got nothing.
Well, it's a holiday miracle.
We're going to need a bit more holiday cheer to crack that shield!
Anyone that's not me have an idea?
Finish delivering the presents, of course.
I think the broken sleigh might make that difficult.
Well then, Saint Kinsey to the rescue!
Hang on, where'd you get these?
You can't stop Christmas just because of a crashed sleigh and a few broken presents. I figured since you gave me the spaceship, I might as well help save the holidays.
You put my workshop out of business, young lady.
Santa, I'd never want to step on your toes like that.
Oh, he's just teasing you. It's impossible to tell the difference with him sometimes.
You think it's cheer, but you cannot see. All of these people now serve me!
Ross is converting more people! Keep it up! He's getting desperate!
Look on in wonder. Here comes Claws to tear you asunder.
Oh, shit. We're fucked.
No! He used up all his power just to strike himself. We have to kill him now!
Surely nothing's stopping him.
I don't understand it. He should be dying.
Well, that's because he's protected by the hatred and greed of those still on the naughty list. Only one thing can cure that.
Hearing and sharing. Oh, I know. Claws needs his own top-of-the-line laptop and bondage harness.
Well, it wouldn't be a holiday without new bakeware and a flamethrower.
Bioengineered arm.
Just want to be clear. You can't murder your way onto the nice list.
Santa,
You never believed in me. But despite that, you spread cheer to the people of Steelport. You saved the holiday, and for that, I thank you. But it takes more than one good deed to show a change of heart.
I know, Santa.
Listen, the night isn't over yet. Experience the joy of Christmas, not because it will keep me from becoming a god tyrant, but because it feels good to spread joy to strangers and build memories with family and friends. You do that, and I'll put you on the nice list.
Are you sure there's time?
It's Christmas. There's always time for a miracle. Yeah!
Bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell time and jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air. What a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is a
one horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling feet. That's the jingle bell rock.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell chime and jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing, jingle bell square.
What's your best score?
No, no, this isn't about me. Besides, I've had many, many years of experience.
No, you just don't want to say, so you can't be beaten.
Don't worry, I'm a natural in the air.
Well, slave life can be tricky, what with all those presents weighing you down.
That's the same excuse you used when you brought it back dented and missing the front panel back in 1931.
Well, at any rate, you can use the sleigh to deliver presents to nice people and cold to those who are naughty.
Piece of cake.
Oh, that sounds good right now. Think I'll go get me a piece.
Try not eating the whole thing in one sitting for once.
So how long have you two been together?
Long. Really, really long.
And I love her just as much now as I did back then.
Oh, it's not always perfect, but I admit it does work out.
I imagine it gets pretty lonely up at the North Pole without anyone else around.
Oh, the elves are all the friends we need, and each other.
That's easy for you to say. You haven't been around the last 50 years. It's like watching over hundreds of children who just want to play with toys and eat candy and pelt you in the ass with snowballs all day.
But that's part of being an elf. It's only natural for them to be children at heart. Happy elves are the best elves.
Yeah? Oh, fine. When you come back, I'm going on vacation for a few decades, and let's see how you handle it. We'll be right back.
relaxing.
Shot should do nicely.
Glad I'm not over there.
I think people are very happy about getting hot coals.
Well, the holiday season is all about giving and sharing. Coal or not, they are still receiving something.
Third-degree burns aren't really on anyone's wish list, honey.
Then perhaps next year they will learn and end up on the nice list.
So very relaxing.
Okay, I have to ask her. Where are the reindeer?
Oh, they won't fly with anyone but me.
Seems kind of elitist of them.
Oh, it's not that. It's just the last time I let someone else take them out. Well, things didn't go so well.
That's an understatement. Prancer got in a fight and came back missing part of his hoof. And Vixen came back pregnant.
I thought all the reindeer were male.
With a name like hers, are you really that surprised?
Love is heavy.
Oh, that shit stinks!
Hey there, everybody! I'm Nobby, with my partner, Whack.
On a break from making shoes and wooden ponies.
To bring you Professor Kanky's latest game for children of all ages.
As long as they're adults. It sure feels great to be out of that sweatshop, Nobby.
I believe you mean workshop, Whack.
You'd think so, Nobby. You'd think so.
Well, it sure is nice to get some fresh air anyway.
Way better than breathing in paint fumes for 16 hours a day, that's for sure.
Well, you're not wrong, but hey, let's check in on our competitor.
Hey,
our contestant go. This is truly impressive work, all in the name of the holidays.
Throwing people through hoops with your mind is the name of the holidays?
Look around you, Wack. Trees, menorahs, the festive spirit is all around us.
I don't remember any carols about death and dismemberment, Nobby.
Hey, be fair now. There's very little dismemberment in mind over murder, only concussion.
Okay, I stand corrected.
I prefer to think of this game as a metaphor. The people, menorahs, and trees are gifts being stuffed in a virtual stocking. The player is not that far off from being Santa Claus, really, when you think about it.
Seriously, Nobby. Seriously?
See you all next time
at Kill Stuff with Your Mind, the game.
Ugh. Oh, Wack.
To the holiday edition of Mind Over Murder, everybody. In the true tradition of the holiday.
Oh, are we going through this again?
No, I mean it. It's been a fun romp so far, and I'm excited to see where this goes.
Really?
Absolutely.
Just like that, huh?
Hey, don't question it, Nobby. Let's get to the action. I have to say, I've heard rumors that the head of the Saints was lacking in the holiday spirit, but I just don't see it.
I agree. The cheer and joyfulness in their face as they throw people through spinning hoops is downright infectious.
Like a cold sore.
Or laughter.
Or the hiccups.
I think maybe you mean yawn.
You said it, not me. What? That was funny.
Let's get back to the game, shall we?
My pleasure.
Oh!
Oh, yeah!
Santa, huh? Oh, what a pair!
An unlikely combination, Whack. But you know what? I think it works.
I agree. A bulbous-headed cat man with giant freaky eyes and a jolly old elf who eats too many cookies. They're like matches in gasoline.
Or chocolate and peanut butter.
In fact, with a Genki-themed holiday, kids can trade in those dreams of sugar plums for psychotropic nightmares of homicidal felines and scantily dressed murderous cosplayers.
Genki isn't meant for kids, Whack.
I'm not sure Genki is meant for anyone, Nobby.
Except our contestants, you mean.
There's always an exception. I gotta say, this mind over murder thing is growing on me. In fact, it's actually pretty fun to watch.
Well, Whack, wait, you know what? Frankly, it took you long enough.
Whoa, Nobby, what's with the attitude?
What's with the attitude? You spent how long grousing and bitching, and now that it's almost over, you're finally on board with it?
Well, you know, it's fun.
What about all that talk of dismemberment and all that Santa paranoia shit?
Nobby, whoa, man. Whoa, come on. You're living in the past. I'm an elf who lives in the present.
I'm gonna shove you into a present.
Already coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, the contestant did an A-plus super job. We hope you enjoyed this holiday edition of Mind Over Murder. I guess it's back to the sweatshop with us, eh, Nobby?
Workshop, Whack. It's called a workshop.
Whatever.
Happy holidays, everybody!
Welcome back to more Holiday Madness, courtesy with Professor Genki's very special Mind Over Murder. How are you doing today, Wack?
What? Oh, yeah, welcome back.
You don't seem to have your head in the game, Wack. Is there something wrong?
What? No, not at all. I'm just wondering exactly how much attention Santa is paying right now.
What do you mean?
You know, is he around? Is he watching?
Of course Santa's watching. He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He even knows if you've been bad or good.
Don't give me that propaganda, Nobby. We all know the truth.
Now, how about that competitor, huh?
Down, what's next?
Another slam dunk job by our contestants.
Hey, you said to be enthusiastic. Yeah, they were great. Easily the best performance I've ever seen at anything. Truly, if there were an award for best in everything all the time, this person would win it every year.
Dial it down a bit, buddy.